Customer engagement is the newest buzzword in marketing, and for great reason, because your customers, potential and current, are literally everywhere. As the internet has grown and continues to grow, the number of platforms you can reach your customer on grows as well. Gone are the days of only seeing customers when they walk into your storefront. So today, I'll be unpacking customer engagement, why it's important, how to measure it, and how to create a great customer engagement strategy that works. Before I do, go ahead and like this video to help others find it on YouTube, and subscribe so you can see more videos that help you dominate marketing online. By the end of this video, you'll be equipped with the knowledge to drive sales and increase your repeat purchases, all through customer engagement. So, what is customer engagement? In the simplest form, customer engagement is the act of communication with your customers across multiple marketing channels. In today's world, customer engagement can happen in many places, through email, text messages, social media, your website, your ads, review sites, in person, and via other channels. Now, you might be thinking, Karan, I get it. My customers are everywhere and I need to be there too. But you know what? That sounds exhausting. Well, let me tell you just how important customer engagement is. First, customer engagement creates a stronger connection and loyalty with your customers. They have to meet you first and hang out with you a little bit to know if it's a good match. By providing value through multiple channels, you give them more opportunities to know who you are and how you can help them, thus increasing your brand recall and the likelihood of purchasing and purchasing again. Second, customer engagement provides more chances to upsell and to cross-sell. With proper data and segmentation from customer engagement, you can begin to understand the specific needs and behaviors of each customer. This allows you to personalize and recommend products and services that provide increased value to your customers and better customer lifetime value and order size for your business. In summary, customer engagement is the first and the last impression the customer has on your business, which makes it extremely important to businesses who want to build a brand of customers who know them and are loyal to them. So, how do you measure customer engagement? The measurement of customer engagement differs depending on the channel used. Let's take a look at each one. When analyzing your website for customer engagement, the following metrics are important: time on site, or how long people stay on your website, your bounce rate, the percentage of people who visit one page on your site and leave, repeat visitors, the number of people who have visited your site more than once, form fields, the number of quality form fields you have on your website, the number of purchases or leads received from your site, and conversion rate, the percentage of people who visit your site and convert into a sale or a lead. Now, all of these metrics can be found using Google Analytics, a free website tool from Google that allows you to measure your website activity. Next is ads. When analyzing your ads for customer engagement, the following metrics are important: click-through rate, the percentage of people who saw your ad and clicked on your ad; conversion rate, the percentage of people who clicked your ad and then converted. All of these metrics can be found within your ad platforms under data or insights. Let's talk about social media. When analyzing your social media channels for customer engagement, the following metrics are important: engagement rate, the percentage of people that saw your post and engaged with your post; follower growth, the ongoing growth rate of your fans and followers. All of those metrics can be found within the insights of the social media platforms you're using. All right, emails and text messaging. When analyzing your email marketing and text message marketing for customer engagement, you want to look at the following metrics: open rate, the percentage of people who received your email or text message in their inbox and opened it; click-through rate, the percentage of people who opened your email and clicked through to some link you had within the email or text message; unsubscribe rate, the percentage of subscribers who unsubscribe from your email list or your text message list; list growth rate, the percentage growth rate of subscribers to your email list or text message list. And lastly, conversion rate, the percentage of people who click through from your emails and text messages and then convert it. All of these metrics mentioned can be found within the reports of the email marketing platform or text message marketing platform you use for individual emails and texts and your overall account. All right, reputation platforms. When analyzing reputation platforms for customer engagement, the following metrics are important. Number of reviews, the number of reviews you obtain, and overall rating, the overall rating or score of your business. These metrics can be found on all review platforms such as Google My Business and Yelp. Now that you know what metrics you should be measuring and monitoring to understand the performance of your customer engagement, let's take a look at a few tips and tricks for better customer engagement. Tip number one, define your goals and your KPIs. By this, I mean answer the following questions. How often will I post? How often will I send out emails? What is your advertising strategy? How quick will you respond to messages, comments, and emails? What is your plan to increase average order value or repeat purchases? All right, tip number two, track results and make improvements. There are those that have goals, and there are those that track goals. Only those who put extreme effort into understanding how their company is performing with customer engagement will be able to make adjustments and improvements to their customer engagement to drive sales and repeat purchases. All right, tip number three, segment your audiences. When you segment your audiences properly, you show potential customers what they need to see to make a purchasing decision based on where they are in the customer journey. Also, your marketing feels more personal and specific. And lastly, you simply get better customer engagement. Here are a few ways you can segment your audiences for better personalization. Pages visited or not visited, interests, geography, engagement level, purchase value, and date of last interaction. Every channel you engage with your customer on is important. Focus on creating consistent engagement and measuring your results. With the right customer engagement strategy, you can increase your brand awareness, increase your sales, and increase your repeat purchasers. If you haven't already, like this video and make sure you subscribe so you don't miss another one that can help you grow online. I'm Karan from Life Marketing. Until next time.